lights go off, it's on. And here we go.
There's a couple riders in the back kind of jump, but Cameron Bobier is trying to get the lead down into turn one, and it looks like he's going to do that, Greg. Matthew Schultz trying to go around the outside of Gerloff. Oh, Gerloff stuffs it back underneath him. They ran 31-2, 30.5 for J.D. Beach.
Aaron, sorry. Look
there
at
you
Aaron.
Go. Yep.
Aaron goes up the inside.
Made a straight line of it. Here comes Garrett Gerloff trying to fire right back as they go. This is the section, Greg, that I talked about prior to our show where we could see some fireworks, and we're starting to see it now. J.D. Beach is on the back.
ABC Brakes Superbike Racing at its finest, and Heron now makes a move past his teammate, so he's going to slot himself into second position. All of a sudden, Josh Heron is on the gas and on the move.
So that was probably a little bit earlier. He gets a great drive out of turn five, down into turn six, and able to make that pass. So now you got the attack Yamaha sitting in fourth. We got three Yamahas occupying the top four spots.
So there you go.
And they both just ended up running them both off. He was committed to trying to go past, and you're going to see when they came out of here, Garrett actually put his hand up and
wasn't necessarily a shot. What it was Garrett sucking.
Got in there too.
J.D. Beach right into that mistake.
And got, well, he went underneath him there and surprised J.D. J.D. had to stand it up, but his speed carried him out there, Greg. So.
Oh, yeah. 10 laps to go in this one. Bobier's had his way. But Jason, I mean, it feels like it's getting tense up here in the booth at this moment. It just looks like there are five riders that can throw a shot at him. And they do. The first one is Josh Heron. Can he keep it tidy? And does he have pace to pull away? Bobier now knows who is behind him this whole time.
We saw Josh planning this a lap earlier. As you can see, he just slides up underneath Cameron as they head down into this attitudes. He looks tremendously fast out of turn seven, has a good drive. Yosh Bike looks geared perfectly out of there, gets up alongside the Yamaha and was able to make that pass.
Oh, Gerloff has gotten by.
Yes, Tony.
Tony Elias. So there goes the 31 of Gerloff. Oh, and Elias is going to fight right back in turn one. They're side by side. He sends it sideways. He gets it down to the apex. And so he'll grab that spot back.
Now Cameron's going to get to go to school a little bit. Look at Tony. Makes a big lunge up the inside of Cameron Bobier. So Cameron, just like that, in the span of less than a lap, has gone from first to third. And Matthew Schultz has got by Gerloff as well. So the number 11, Westby Racing R1, has now moved himself up into that fourth spot. And it looks like J.D. Beach. Garrett Gerloff makes a mistake in turn seven. Just like that, he's back to sixth place. The apex speed at that corner, Greg, and that's what's going to make him especially hard to pass, because he's going to be able to get down to the apex of these corners like we've talked about so much and make it very difficult for these guys.
And Schultze has moved his way up into third around Camp Bobier. So the number 11 Westby Racing Yamaha, Matthew Schultz, is there. So we have three factory bikes.
Yeah, behind though. Oh, who's J.D. Beach? Crashes turn six and seven. J.D. Beach goes down.
In frustration.
Wow.
So just as Beach had his podium in sight, down goes the Attack Performance Estenson Racing Yamaha rider.
We'll have a look here. J.D. runs out wide.
Oh,
turns
he tried
it.
To turn
yeah,
it.
Yeah, he tried to turn it and got over the curbing. And you could see it. He just there's a curbing over there, Greg.
Yeah.
It looked like it wasn't
it's
as
like
smooth.
It's like gator teeth.
Yeah,
and it just literally disconnected the Dunlop tire from the surface and down he went.
What is going on? Josh Heron's got a problem.
Oh, no.
So, yeah, that might have been something. Not sure why, but let's have a look. He goes into turn one and just goes straight. So
can't get it slowed down, maybe?
Yeah.
On this final lap of the race, Tony Elias, the Spaniard, the 2017 EBC Brakes Superbike Champion, trying to get that back from Cameron Bobier, was back as far as fifth place, has worked his way into a race win. Trying to wheelie across the line here at altitude, takes the checkered flag in fine style, and Tony Elias adds his fourth win of the season. Only podium finishes for Tony Elias when he's finished a race. What a year he's having so far.
Matthew Schultz comes across second. Garrett Gerloff, tremendous ride in third. Cameron Bobier, fourth. Looking to see if Jake is across. Jake Lewis, top five finish for the M4XStar Suzuki team.
Outstanding run by Jake Lewis.
Yep.
Was back there watching the mayhem in front of him. They dropped off like flies, and another top five finish for the Kentucky native. And a good bit of information. Jason Uribe in eighth place on the Honda.
Gagne, Uribe, and Anthony almost came across the line together, and I'm happy to see Josh Heron did get six, so he got something out of today, even though I know it's not what he wanted, but he got some points out of it. But that battle for seventh between Gagne, Uribe, and Anthony was all the way to the line.